Your phone's going off. Must be a notification from In the Breezeway. Welcome to the In the Breezeway, everybody, with Franny and Beebs. I'm Franny.
I'm Beebs.
Way over there to the left.
Way over here, yep. Oh, sorry. That's coffee.
They bottle coffee.
That's maple syrup. That's maple syrup I caught today in the back here.
The only thing Canadian about that is that canister on it.
Well, we got the Riddells with us tonight. This is Gilbert. And this is Justin over here,
a.k.a. Study. Now, we met you guys at Sherbert Lake. Met up with you again at Hollyroot Jamboree. Had a little tune. Both spots. Through mutual friends, Americans.
Yeah.
And they just happened to be there
in
here as well.
In the house.
I was the quiet one. I had all the
Actually, he was right.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah.
Well, I was training for the ministry.
Yeah, me and him both.
Did you hear? Did you hear Brownie?
Yeah.
Brownie. If you're at a jamboree and you're considered loud, you've got to be louder than that man right there.
That's how I find him. I can hear him loud in six cameras over.
Yep. Well, so,
we love Brown.
Great to have you on the show.
Thanks for having us.
Oh, this is awesome. And thanks, Kev, for tipping me off with these guys. Kevin's kind of a scout on his own out there.
Yeah, he is. Well, they've been good to us.
Yep,
they've
been good to everybody.
Yeah, they are.
Awesome. Yeah. So, you got some gigs coming up this summer.
Yeah, we got a pretty good summer coming up. I play with a couple more people, a little girl, and I call him my dad, he's a few years older than I am. But we do, we don't like doing hotels because we've gone through that.
Yep.
You know, and I'm just a little bit older now. So I try to stay away from that. But what we do is we do a lot of things, and my goal is, especially with Justin, is to keep, the thing for any is to keep the valid point of true country music, you know, the George Jones and the Merles and the Whalens and all that, to the right level so that it'll carry on to our children.
Your grandchildren.
Yeah.
And it already has. And we were talking earlier, actually, about how much the older country, when you go to the jamborees or you go out and listen, you even go out into the bars and you're hearing a lot of classic country.
A lot. It's coming back.
Yeah.
It's
nice to see. And I don't think they'll ever get rid of it. You know, like I just think that style, that heart.
Well, it's three chords and the truth.
So that's right. That's right.
It's music for the working man and woman.
Amen.
I've been working on that fourth chord with you for a while.
Yeah, I know. I'm getting
B minor.
Now I just got to stop making them words in my head.
So what have you got to start us off with tonight? Let's just get right into a tune here.
This was a real honor, and I think we might better do it, George.
All right, huh?
This little guy here beside me was doing a good job of George.
Yeah. I'm glad you noticed I lost a pound this week. I am a little numb.
Yeah. That's great. There's a couple of songs I have, and one of them is George's Tennessee Whiskey.
Right on.
I used to spend my nighttime in a bar room. I knew, but you rescued me from drinking for the bottle. I came back from being too far gone. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. Strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. Not a steady stone on your love all the time. Now my lead player there, he had a thing we caught. He was doing things. I had looked in all the wrong places, from the bottom of the bar.
Messaged the show before it tonight and made sure that we can hook him up. I hope you're watching out there, Gary.
Yeah, you know, he's a good guy. Gary is, I've known Gary for, you know, I'm only about 47, but I've known him for about 55 years. He's just a super, super person.
And does a bit of jamming with you.
Yeah, and he goes around to every jamboree. He supports every jamboree in this area every year, him and his wife.
Wow.
So, and he's a hell of a guitar player, too.
Yeah. And a mandolin player.
Yeah. Well, maybe we get up to Bancroft, we'll do a...
Yeah.
We'll do a...
Well, this summer, when you come down to my little thing in September.
Yes.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll make sure that we get to know him.
That'd be good.
Well, that'd be real good.
Hey, love it.
I might not look the same when I get back from that one. So, I'm looking forward to it now.
This next question... The chances, you got a pretty good chance of answering it, but what's the first song that you learn on the guitar? What's the first song you learn on the guitar?
My favorite memory.
Yeah.
Actually, no, that's actually, it was a Wayne Rodstad song. Yeah. Actually, to tell you the truth.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was a Wayne Rodstad song.
Wasn't he on that TV show?
No, it's called From the Beginning. I think we got it in the playlist here.
That's my song. Yeah. But anyways... Mine was The Bottle Let Me Down by Merle.
Merle?
I've done that in 1973 at the high school.
Merle was one of the first artists I learned how to sing a Merle song first. So.
Yeah.
You got an old time song for us, please?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Which one do you want to do? Merle song? Yeah. Yeah. Sing into the mic.
Hey, I started loving you again. Right back where I've really always been. Yeah, I got over you just long enough to lift my heart again. Then today I started loving you again. What a fool I was to think of. Goodbye. With only these few million tears I cried. But I should have known the worst was yet to come. And that crying time for me had just begun. Today I started loving you again. I'm right back where I've really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heart expand. And today I started loving you again. Today I started loving softly.
And I'm right back where we've really always been. I got over you.
Hit more maple syrup, that's all that is.
You're pretty good at passing that.
I know, well, Fred is not always handy, and I tried to watch him.
Fred is always handy.
I watch old video clips of Fred, and I picked up there some really good habits on how to serve beer quicker. Yeah, he's a champion.
Did you get new glasses, Fred?
Yes.
Looks good. Yeah, it looks really good.
I can actually see it now.
You know, it's pretty funny. I can just kick in here, can I? But anyway,
sure.
Yes. For the last year.
He's not one to talk.
Yeah, for the last year, I've heard about this, you know, Fred. And you hear it every week, Fred's here, Fred's not here. I said, Justin, who's Fred? Do you not know Fred? I said, no. He says, well, I'm not saying nothing until you meet him. I'm Fred, I met him tonight.
I didn't even know he drank until I seen him sober one day. Rolling around the yard. That's what he's doing. Just taking out the recycle.
Just somebody to pick on, hey, Fred. He gives it back, everybody. Yeah. First of all, Fred does give it back. Amen.
If you're not teasing your best friend, but there's something wrong, right?
Or your spouse.
Yeah, she gets a lot of needling.
Stacy wants Fred to dance for us.
Yeah, we'll get Fred to dance a little later on. But we'd like to thank everybody for their nice compliments and every week after week after week joining us here on the Breezeway. But we'd really like you to hit the share button on there and share it around.
Yeah,
I know that we've got it up to Bancroft, live streaming Bancroft tonight.
In Newfoundland, I bet you Kathleen Pittman's out there watching, and down in Oregon, the Corn Belt there, Joe
McCurry. What time would it be for a mainlander? What time would it be down in Newfoundland now?
Yeah, I'm going to have different.
Yeah.
A quarter after
7? No. According to our watch.
Yeah. Around
9 o'clock.
Yeah.
We're not late.
Oh, well, they're ahead of us already.
It's late.
I have to do a lot more drinking to catch up to them. They got a 2-hour start on us.
Are you boys still playing quite a bit? Hey, practicing?
Yeah.
Right on. Good lads.
Yeah.
We'll pan the camera over to our buddies here a little later on. Maybe we can get to talk to them.
What do you got picked out for his hair now?
You ever give me?
Or stubby?
In the shadows of my
head. Oh, there's a beauty song.
In the shadow of my mind, I see. Of my mind, just the girl I used to know, long time ago. I done her wrong just one too many times, but when I lay down at night and I turn out the lights, she goes. Of my mind,
guy turned out the light. He goes walking through the shadow of my mind. Now I'm trying to forget. Hell, I haven't forgot yet. Through the days I've seen, we've been okay. But when I lay down at night and finally close my eyes, she goes walking through the shadows. In the shadow of my mind, I see just the way she used to be. When I'm alone at night and I turn out the light, she goes walking through the shadow of my mind. Walking through the shadow of my mind.
That's good.
This is guitar season coming up for you.
Yeah, it is, actually, yeah.
We were talking about that earlier,
yeah,
right?
It is you guitar don't want to season for me. I don't really get out much, eh? So I don't play much.
Yeah.
What? Pretty quiet tonight.
Yeah. I gotta say, this is probably the most quiet.
Yeah.
You gotta play to the crowd. Eh? It's a nice, calm, quiet crowd tonight. Oh,
yeah. You played to this crowd before.
Family television.
That's a different one.
Because it was mommy. Yeah. Yeah. Because it was mommy.
Yeah. Okay. I think I gotta get my dad to do a Daryl McCall song here.
Ooh, yeah. Dream of a Dreamer.
Yeah.
I love this
great
song.
Story behind it?
No, just good song. Good song.
Lost my pickup card game in New Orleans.
Yeah.
Lost my girl and a stranger in L.A. Lost my girl kitchen in a motel, and I lost my mind somewhere along the way.
Don't forget.
Can't you see I'm dying on my feet, walking my grave you stole to me. Them old memories appearing up my mind. They're the dream of a dreamer gone blind. The bright lights and songs play of the good times. That old journey and the ashes of my youth have been scattered by the afterlife and wine of yesterday. Can't you see I'm dying on my feet, walking to stone to be. Them old memories tearing up my mind. There's a dream, well, I'm a dreamer gone blind. Got the dream of a dreamer.
Thank you. That is a song I had forgotten of all of it. I haven't heard that in forever.
I had it on a cassette tape with Gene Watson.
Yeah.
Well,
That's Jeff McCall sings that?
Daryl McCall.
Every time I sing, I want to go up and plant corn.
Hi, Terry.
Where corn don't grow, eh?
Hello, cousin.
My brother, Jamie?
Yeah.
Howdy, Jamie.
John Kern says, oh my God, I hope you guys don't sing too long. I only have 10 beers left.
Bring them over here.
Well, if you're any kind of a beer drinker like Beebs, that's good for 3 songs.
the one that I really want to see on here is Joyce Planter. Joyce and Bernie support us no matter where we go.
And are they their players?
No. They're just family. They're just family, and they're... Now, they just come back from spending 3 or 4 months in Florida. Just pissed me right off. They didn't even ask me down.
Give them a good shout out.
But they're super people, and they support you guys. They support Napanee.
Well, thank you very much.
Yeah.
And like I said, get out and support the live music. I mean, it is definitely making a comeback around.
Yeah, you want to keep it, you got to go support it. So right. Simple as that. And I mean, we're out there, and we're just doing it. You know, for the money, we wouldn't be doing it.
No, but yeah. I tell you, you meet some of the best and nicest people around.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. Yeah. A lot of them are here tonight.
And then there's Jeff Wright.
If that's all that comes about music with me is the people I've met, I can go to my grave freaking happy.
Amen. I hear you.
Amen. Yeah. Don't get me all sappy, and I'm going to have to switch to whiskey. So you better think it's another one.
Lee says, I can't go to whiskey. I got to drive home.
Pull that mic stand in about if it's too far for him.
Yeah, it is. He's got to sing into the mic.
Yeah, yeah. I was going to mention how much that
is. Yeah, so
we got
anybody
some requests, too, for some Waylon and some George Strait.
Okay.
I got some Waylon right now for you.
Is that right? I like these, you know... Every one of the artists that come on Beeps are always got to see this hidden set list down here.
I know. Yeah.
I got my eyes on boys. Like every artist, you don't step off some do, some don't, but not very often.
It's a set list that my dad made up.
Well, I'll just tell you something. This is to the kids growing up, friend. Is that when you go out and entertain, you know, and it takes a long time, but you need to memorize every song because you can't. Look at a page and sing.
And feel it.
You have to memorize it. When you memorize it, look at these two kids right here. Okay, when they go up and sing and play, they don't have no sheet in front of them. They do it right from the heart. And they're just...
It would have been helpful for me in that first 5-minute segment, though.
For sure. Listen, Harold will not... Hold that against you for dropping a couple of words.
I had to go back and ask Randy, did I just make up my own words in that?
I said, you did. You did well writing
I was having
a song that was already wrote.
I got home early and started burning stuff, and then you know the rest of the story. And I mean, in the back,
I was going to say.
Don't get the wrong impression about me. God, I got to go to church on Sunday.
No, I heard this live down in Hollywood. This next one.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you?
Yes, I did.
Did you sing it then?
Yeah.
I know.
Open mic.
Did I mess it up?
I was kind of
I'm famous for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna do some whaling here.
So am I.
Don Williams also did it. I don't know how much people have done it. I'll tell it all in word. God knows I tried. It's an awful weight. Country boy's life to look in the mirror in total surprise. The hair on my shoulders, the age in my eyes. A man of my life. Should have made you the gentleman's wife. Amanda, light of my life. Fate should have made you
Gilbert wife. Well, it's a measure of people who don't understand the pleasures of life in a hillbilly band. I got my first guitar when I was 14. I'm pushing 40, still wearing jeans. Amanda, light of my life, fate should have made you a gentleman's wife. Amanda, light of my life, fate should have made you a gentleman's wife. 'Cause fate should have made you a gentleman's wife.
Thank you.
How's your nerves are gone?
My nerves are gone. I thought we forgot what we're doing. I was like, geez, we're having a big party here today. That was great.
It's awesome.
And I remember, you think it'll work tomorrow. That took all the fun of it. Well, for a little while.
Right. Now, you're always at the open mics, Sherbert.
Yeah, we do a lot of them, man.
A lot. I see a lot of them on there.
Yeah, we do it for good cause. We're raising money for Postal District 3. Not only for the rink, but a majority is for the rink, but it's also for the whole Ball Diamond, call it what you will, sports complex. We're in the stages right now. I know.
Very worthy cause.
Very worthy cause. I seen an email yesterday. The electrical drawings are going in. We should be getting them back soon. Yeah. It's been a really crazy winter. I know Robin Gould, give a shout out to her. She's been basically stick handling it. Her and Leslie. I was supposed to have a big part in that, but times are busy, eh?
Yeah.
So, no.
Yeah. You're under the spotlight now, I can feel it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Silent partner.
Yeah, I'm a silent partner. Consultant.
Well, you guys do wonderful things up there, and I always enjoy it. So when you guys are, and I enjoy the videos you guys throw up, they're just not long enough.
Yeah, we want more.
Yeah, I understand. You know how it is. Yeah, I know exactly how it is.
It's kind of nice to see there's like, 3/4 of the camping family here.
Yeah. Yeah. That's good.
And it's good. It's good. Like I said, it's good.
We get together with a big hand.
Yes.
Big hand for all the campers.
Oh, all right. Camping season.
All the reasons my liver hurts on Mondays. It's all your fault. And the bruises up and down my arm are atrocious.
For all you lovely people that wouldn't come out and join us,
yeah.
We still love you.
Well, we did have a little bit of an idea. I'm still kind of excited for it. We did have a little bit of an idea of where we were trying to get us down at the Covert Legion Village. They've got a pub off to the side down there, and we thought that they would really enjoy your music down there. So, but they had other stuff going on down there tonight, but that doesn't mean that we won't. I just think that that would be
awesome.
It'd be awesome. And
my mother-in-law was in there. Awesome.
So... That was part of the reason your mother-in-law's...
The old buzzard's in there, yeah.
Is she watching?
No, she's off the deep river. We got rid of her for a while. She's been driving us nuts.
You know, she can't bring this back up and listen.
No, she won't. She know anyway, you little bugger. She'd say to me, like, hey, what are you trying to do to me? And then I'd go over and she'd offer me a shot of whiskey. Like, I don't even drink that shit. But she keeps around for medicinal purposes.
If we keep quiet, he just goes up for a minute, and then he'll look at you and he'll say, what do you got first?
Yeah,
that's right. Yeah, we're going to do a couple little tunes here back to back. Is that okay?
That's great. No, oh, I
need a little more volume on my thing. Because
you got to sing into it.
I know, but I'm having trouble here.
You can push it closer to him, so you're leaning forward.
I always like getting close to stuff. That's better.
Me too, that's what I am.
That's what I need.
Yeah, well, I'll just give you a little more sidewalks.
There you go.
I'm sorry about that.
No problem, and I can give you a little more too.
No. And Fran asked me what my first song was. It was you know, it was Burroughs, the Bible Let Me Down. And another one is a Don Gibson's tune, Sensuous Woman. And,
Can you get me in here?
Yeah. I'd like maybe to do both of them back to back.
Is that okay?
Yeah. Give her. Each night, I lean in my room when it's over. But tonight, your memory found me good and sober. I couldn't drink enough to get you off my mind. And tonight, the bottle let me down. Around the one different friend I saw around. Tonight, the bottle let me down. I always have a bottle that I can turn to. Every day, lately the wine don't take effect when you do, and I'm hurting in no familiar way. And tonight, the bottle let me down.
Muscles found you cast all over me.
woman, woman, sensuous woman. You control the world I'm living in. Woman, sensuous woman. Release my body and let me live again. Release my body and let me live again.
Reminds me of my girlfriend when I was in about grade 7. Yeah, she moved away and I haven't seen her since.
Well, we did a little research while we were off. You know who we were talking to?
Jeff.
No, well, we were talking to Jeff too, but we were talking to Mother.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
And she was mentioning. Gilbert, why don't you tell the story about the first time this lad was on stage, 5 years old? Sing it. I never knew you hit the stage. You hit the stage pretty young.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I have my mother's. My mother was, God love my mother. She was born in 1923, was married. My dad died in 1971. I was 20 years old. And she was married 3 times after that. And the last guy she was married to, dead or two, died. The last one couldn't handle it, so he left. But she was a wonderful person, you know, and in God's eyes, there was never anybody any better than my mother. And when she got married, Justin and I sang a little song. But this is not a good.
No, no, we don't have to do the song. I was just talking.
Looking back, Texas.
Yeah,
and just looking back, Texas.
That's awesome.
Is that what I wanted to change my name?
Yeah.
That was early.
Yeah. That was priceless, though, eh?
Okay, let's go over some of the signatures on the guitar, because he didn't buy it like that.
No, a lot of these...
Are these good time signatures?
Yeah.
Oh, look, there's people in the crowd laughing, man.
There's my daughter, right?
That's Woody, yeah.
Yeah, that's Sam, my pride and joy. I have 2 kids, Sam and Jake. Hi, guys. I have Steve Patico, probably one of the best guitar players in all the world.
Yes.
Jimmy Flint. That is the rest. I'm not quite sure. My dad, obviously.
Tom Hall.
Tom Hall. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And then I have a little thing here that my daughter helped me put on there. It's a little picture. She found this for me, and she gave me this little picture, and it says it's two people standing beside each other. The one guy has a happiness jar, right? And the one guy says, where'd you get that from? And he says, where'd you find that? And he says, I created it myself. So, because she says I'm always happy. Eh? So,
cool. That's awesome. There's always good stories behind stuff like that. I know.
Amen.
Somebody else has got a few signatures on his guitar there.
Yeah, I do too.
This guitar has been throwing paddle boats, everything. Yeah, and it still works all right.
Tom Boat Fender, you just fell air to.
Okay. Oh, that was my first one.
No, oh, mine.
Oh, your Fender you just gave me.
Yeah. What, do we have a, did we pass one down, did we?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Oh, well, yeah. Awesome. That's always good to hear.
Yeah. That's my pride and joy.
Anyways.
You don't want the stories, eh? You guys want to get playing. What's happening?
Yeah. No, I think that Fender, I think it's like...
Listen, it's just like a good car. You need some fuel. Why don't we get a friend to come on in, bring a beer delivery in.
Amen.
And come on in, Fred.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Hey, Fred.
Oh, thanks, Fred.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Fred. Come on over here, Fred, and sit down there. I'll give you the mic, and you can run them through a couple questions.
Thank you, Fred.
Well, that's a bit of the trouble.
Much needed.
I thought you needed it.
Thank you. Right on. Thank you, Fred.
Yeah. You're welcome.
I'll drink it. I don't know. First one today.
Well, listen to you guys. I see you like the old classic country, right?
Yep, absolutely.
But you've got no Stonewall Jackson, right?
I personally don't.
I do, but I won't sing to me.
That sucks.
I love him so.
You know another guy called Joe?
Oh, yeah. But
how about the other one?
But I can't sing him. Why? Because there's two or three people around Enterprise that sing that almost every week. And I've got to the point now where I said to myself, you just better not sing that no more because there's just too many people singing.
Yeah.
Yeah, there is.
How about a George Jones song?
Yeah.
Okay, that'll do then.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that suck or what, friend?
Well, man, I'd rather have someone, John. But yeah, that's okay.
He's fussy, any choices.
Sorry, I don't know. I personally don't know any Stonewall Jackson songs.
That's quite all right. Go ahead, do a George Jones. That's good.
Oh, he loved George Jones.
Oh, well, then do
can
it.
You help me? Can you help me with this one?
I've had choices from the day that I was born. I heard voices that told me right from wrong. I had to listen, oh, I wouldn't be here today. Living and dying, the choices I
keep on running or come home and maybe she'd straighten me out, and she did.
Yeah.
No, my dad was a great old time Ernest Tubb, those type of guy things.
Yeah.
And lived on an 800 acre farm that we had. And
did you grow up in Charlotte Lake area?
No, I grew up north of Charlotte Lake on an 800 acre farm and
dairy cows or beef cows?
It was both. Both, yeah, and they had a big family. I had seven uncles and eight aunts.
Cool.
Yeah, a big family. pretty good out of that was is that over the years, the first 15 years probably, I've seen a lot of them die. They all died in their 50s because of heart, except for my one uncle that lived to be 94. I took his genes, by the way. Okay? And no.
He's running around with no genes?
Right on.
Why would you do that?
But anyway, you know, what I really like about this whole story of my life is that out of that thing, my dad used to play at dances, had a great voice, and I found out in the last 2 or 3 years that he had a love affair with a lady that I didn't know about, you know, and at that time it didn't work out. And she told me some stories in the last few years that changed my whole outlook about him, and God love him. And,
so I have uncles and aunts I don't know about?
Oh, no.
Sorry, I took that the wrong way.
Listen, no, we're not going to, no. You're not going to get the extended family version on this show.
That's sort of where I got my thing, and my dad had bought a Martin guitar, a C-type, out of Simpson Sears, and he played that a long time, and I have a sister that's an awesome singer. She's a gospel singer, got a beautiful voice. I have another sister that's a mandolin player that would just scare you. She won't come out of her shell, and
well, the music runs through the family.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Is this, so this is third generation.
Did your grandfather, parents play too?
Oh, yeah.
Four?
Yeah.
So far back as you can remember is...
Yeah, far as back as I can.
Your kids, Stubby?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, actually,
wow, hey, we're going
my young guy, Jacob, he started with the guitar, went out, saved his own money, bought himself a Telecaster Mini, electric guitar. He was doing awesome, and he just said one day, I'm not into it anymore. I want to play the drums. So now he's playing the drums, and he's giving her.
He's turning
to a great one. Yeah, he's right on to the Merle. His favorite song to play is, No, that was on his guitar. It's, one of Merle Haggard's song, I forgot.
Working Man Blue?
No, anyways, he's doing awesome. And he's just, what is it, a year now? I think it was here last weekend.
That's something to have, that, that generations, how many generations.
Yeah. And so,
hello?
Yeah, Fred had it, eh?
Yeah.
Drunk, no.
And I have two other sons that they won't play. Yeah.
He did have it. He had their unplugged, so.
His stubby's been the wild streak with his mother.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a story about my dad's music career here. Hey. I can remember you know, my son's age, my daughter's age,
let's not
Brady and Riley's age,
let's not go there.
He would play basements, people's, you know, houses, bars, whatever, and we'd wake up on a Sunday morning and there'd be people passed out on our floor everywhere.
No, they were sleeping.
So anyways, he decided, I don't know, probably in his mid-40s to give it up for a while, and I think he gave it up for about 10 or 15 years.
I did.
And that's when I decided, I took his guitar and said, you know what, I'm going to learn a few songs, and started playing his guitar and self-taught.
A little hiatus in the music too. When I raised my kids, I kind of let the music slide until they're up and old enough. And
it's hard.
It is. It's nice now. I mean, I'm living large.
Yeah.
Amen.
You know, they're doing wonderful. And
what do you guys do here, Randy and you and Bees?
You know, we always hear that, and it's so beneficial for us to be and to play with so many musicians. I mean, we've already met and played and jammed a couple times and enjoyed them both, and it was great to have these back on the show. But with as many people as we meet, we've got some rock and rollers coming up through the show here. We're gonna expand that and invite.
That's what's cool. Get everybody a chance. Let people get heard.
Yep,
absolutely fun and build a network of friends.
Amen.
And you know it like you said, it rubs off. Our camper family, we've got mandolin players, we've got players, we've got guitar players, drum players, and it's just seemed that they've picked it up since we, you know, got together and
No, we even got Fred to bring her a beer.
Yeah,
so we got a couple a couple new people going to start into the music kind of playing for other people on our bus trip. We've got a special three people that are going to be, anyways, on there playing for everybody, and it's not going to be Biebs and myself. It's our equipment's going to be ready out Sterling, so we've asked some newbies and just learning how to play guitar to
that's good.
Play, and they're doing wonderful too. So we'll break the news to you closer to. But
so give us another tune there.
You know, I'm really impressed with Gary Kelsey falling down from
Yeah. Oh, is that where he's from?
Yeah.
Okay, because he was talking, he would know my Uncle Art and Aunt Merla.
If he's
from around Griffith.
Can I just take?
You can take whatever. This is about you and your son.
Once you get him going, he likes to talk.
I can tell.
But anyways.
We like the stories.
We went up to see Gene Watson in Renfrew, and we got tickets from one of the construction people. We had good seats. You know, we were probably maybe from here to, I don't know, the end of the camper, away from the stage. Anyways, Gary is there. And when we're standing in line, Gary's going in the side door, and he sees me. He says, Gibby, come here. So Holly and I go over. And we ended up, like, from here to there from the stage. Just because...
It's always nice to have friends, eh?
You know, that's just the type of guy he is.
That's awesome. Beebs and I both got to see Gene Watson too. We seen him at the Honky Tonk Lounge up in Peterborough. Nice. We didn't know we were at the same event, but
yeah, that's but I can, we I was. Can tell a whole story about that, but I ain't gonna.
Yeah,
yes, you can.
Not right now.
Play this one, fellas.
Okay, little girl tune. Wished I was down on the summer.
Sponsor.
No, we won't do it. No, Okay. Yeah. I just put those down there to.
I get reading the set list, you know, and things start going through my mind there.
I'm quite surprised he's sticking to it.
You know what we should start is start collecting the set list from the artists that bring the set list in.
Yeah, to sign them and we'll tack them on the wall.
There you go.
I love Hank Williams Jr. I like him.
You'd have been right in the prime of Hank Jr. come along. Yeah. That would have been it.
Him and I are the same age.
Man, kick-ass country went flowing through the veins. Eh?
Right on, yeah. When I'm out entertaining, I love to do about four of his songs, just because the way they are, they're you know, especially with the people that are having a few drinks, and trying to relax. It's all about people.
I ain't gonna do it around here then.
No, it's all about people. The world is so full of so much aggravation. Yeah.
Unless they can get some music and relax. See, I'm gonna give Beebs a second there to give a throw out to the Leafs there, buddy.
I mean, they're doing really good, but they still gotta win two more games. Washington's not gonna lay down and let them, so I mean but so far so good there.
I just noticed all your Leaf
I've been a long time, since I was born, and I'm proud of my team, like everybody else is proud of their team, no matter who you cheer for, you're proud of the team you cheer for.
I'm with you, Beats.
Okay. Go Washington!
Considering we weren't even supposed to make the playoffs, I think we're doing pretty damn good.
Exactly, I thought we got another top five pick, and then we made the playoffs.
He's took it on all year on the show. If you look back on the comments, there's somebody been out there poking him.
Fred asked me the other day what I'd do if they won it, and I said, well, I'm not going to think that far ahead, but I tell you right now, you ever seen a grown man ball? I said, I'd probably ball.
He's one of the biggest Leaf fans.
I've been waiting a long time, and it would mean a lot to me if they won, and I wish I had done it when my dad was still alive so I could experience it with him, but he passed away a long time ago. So
I think if they win the Cup, the first thing I'm going to do is change my pants because I'm going to shift the ones.
Oh, yeah. I might even run and get some new pants.
Stubby's coming along.
I'm going to have to tell my boss I ain't going to come into work for a week. But he's easy going. He's a pretty good guy, my boss.
1967. Time ago.
He'll understand totally, won't he?
What do you got for us, boys?
Hank Jr.?
Okay, yeah. This is a song that when I'm really down, I usually go to my studio, which is upstairs in my off-suite bathroom. That's my studio. I have all my songs all taped over on the wall and that. Everybody that comes, they say, oh, you sing up there, do you? I said, I sure do. I won't be blue anymore. I'll go out on the town. I'll take all my friends, every honky tonk around. They'll help me forget you and the way it used to be. And I won't be blue anymore. The only friend I've got now. Been gone. I think two arms that used to hold you and a heart that nearly broke. And a mind that sometimes wonders how to handle it broke. So I made this promise to myself. I won't be blue anymore. I'll go out on the town. And I'll take all my friends to every honky tonk around. They'll help me forget you and the way it used to be. And I won't be blue anymore. World that they want. Sometimes it doesn't matter. They hold and they
I'll go out on the town and I'll take all my friends, every honky tonk around, and they'll help me forget you.
Take me right back to the Jimmy Lewis, Tex Richardson days with sitting around two old boys that, God bless their soul, are gone, but boy, oh boy, they had it. They had a lot of tunes under their tune after tune after tune.
Franny, he does a really good job of Wayne Brodstead's tune, what's it called?
From the Beginning.
Yeah, From the Beginning. Yeah. And that one of his love life stories that went down the tube. And I try to get him to do Read the Street Queen, but he won't do it. But he does this nice job on this
thank
one,
you.
From the beginning.
He does it. Well, it just sounds like a request. If
yeah,
you had...
well, he does a really good job on it, and it's a love story, eh? And it's one of those ones you got to keep alive. You got to keep alive.
It's a little different than Wayne Rodstad's version, but
yeah. Sorry, you got to make it your own. Right? Yeah.
From beginning, we were lovers, you and I, were never friends, now here we are, like my mother, my father, and all I dream. Can't draw water, the well's gone dry. You can't keep warm, you have no fire. You can't go on, the highway ends. We were lovers, should have been friends. Now the ending is like a story. Two children tired of playing house and feeling empty. The idle hours, feeling weary, feeling alone. You can't draw water, well's gone dry. You can't keep warm, you got no fire. You close the cover, story ends. We were lovers, should have been friends. We were lovers, should have been friends.
Like you've heard these guys for a while, so I just thought I'd give it. Any has got a request to do.
Family tradition.
Family tradition.
Sure. Yeah. Go ahead. one of his songs, it's all right.
I love Family Friends.
Sorry,
Mike. No, it's all right.
It's all good. It's all good.
Breezeway doesn't like it because we don't have a drummer ready to pound me down. Country music singers.
Where are you?
Lately, Tom, I can't fall. After zoned a few hours and me. I guess it's because I kind of changed my direction. I guess I've been changed their family tradition. Now they want to know, hey, why do you drink? Why must you live out the song that you wrote over and over? Everybody makes my prediction. If I get stoned and say all night long, it's a family tradition. Well, I have proud of my daddy's name. Although his kind of music and mine ain't exactly the same. Stop and think it over. Put yourself in my unique position. If I get stoned and sing all night long, go down in some honky tonk and some old slickin' trying to get me some friction. They said, if you can be alone, make an Irish thing that's all night long. It's a family tradition. I know what it takes to bother me. Now I have a love song, ladies. They both tried to kill me in 1893. Doctor said to me, son, how'd you get in this condition? He said, I ain't stuck on just to carry it on a family tradition. Just think how he wanted to know, hey, why? Everybody makes my prediction. If I get stoned and sing all night long, it's a family tradition. I caught a good woman at home who thinks I do no wrong. Time. Friend of mine, good guy.
He told you that?
No, him and I used to drink a lot of beer. 1994, and Christmas time, I quit drinking, never had a drop of 2007. Yeah. So, anyways, the wagon I was on was pretty friggin' high. That's why I fall off it before then. No, I don't drink a lot. I like beer. I'm not scared to say it.
By the way, I see it, after 45, 50 years of working.
42 years.
And it's great to see, as a son, he's enjoying retirement. And
yeah,
he's
sure,
doing
sure.
what he wants to do.
Well, right. You know, it's really good to see you out on the music circuit, because I don't know, is this like the first year, like in a while, that you've done that? Because,
oh, yeah.
Is it? Because I just noticed that this, like, I'm seeing your picture, I'm seeing you're here, like...
That's you better right. know the truth is I'm scared as hell to go and sing anyplace.
Yeah. So am I to this day, and I think today you're
there's
not.
Nothing,
you
there's nothing. There's nothing. Nervous about oh, being no, in the Breezeway no, studio,
no,
is
no,
it?
No. No. Beautiful.
No. It's
actually yeah. it's slapping in the heart.
Everybody.
It's the crowd. It's the crowd.
You may have to get the plywood out and the hammer to get us out here.
We'd like to thank everybody out there for being too. Yeah. We've been having fun here tonight. I know you got a lot of friends and family that's in the studio here tonight.
Absolutely.
Got over 1,200 views already.
Amen.
I want to personally thank
you. Know a lot of people? I mean, that's a lot of people, Gibby.
Oh, no. What I know
you better shout them up, man.
Yeah. Worse
than
me.
How many?
He's worse than me. No, look at me.
Population shower legs. We're all here.
Yeah.
I personally want to thank Freddie and Beebs
yeah.
for having us.
Yeah.
I want to thank Kevin, basically Kevin, for pushing me to do this.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much.
And my dad for saying yes when I asked him.
Yeah. I almost didn't, you know. Yeah. But no, I'm so glad I did.
Me too. Yeah. So,
well, I know you didn't. I know thanks. I was watching the conversation there. You were having back and forth. And
well, it's a great thing to have. I miss my dad.
I don't blame anybody.
He didn't play, but he sang, and I miss that. So, I mean, it's great to see a father and son having fun.
We got a special show coming up for the Beebs there, too.
Yeah, so. Yeah. I've talked to Mom, and she said she'd do two or three kitty wells and stuff like that nice. With me. So.
She's not going to know about it, though.
Yeah, I don't think she'll go live, but I thought maybe we'd just get a clip and throw it on the Breezeway. And yeah, something for me to look at. I told her why, too. Well, someday when you're gone, Dr. Mitt, you know. She's only going to turn 72 on Friday, so I know she don't watch, but happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
I love her. Yeah,
I asked her to sing two or three, and she said she would.
Can you play that us, the song here, if I have a couple people come in and help? Can you play that one?
Which one?
This one here.
Certainly.
Okay. Oh, absolutely, yeah. Kids.
I'll play along, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
But I couldn't do a Breezeway night with these couple lads sitting in. It really is all about the kids, you know, that we had a young lad a couple weeks ago, Charlie.
Yeah, I seen that.
From the Nelson family.
Oh, yeah.
We had a little jam session after.
Nelson, they're awesome.
Nelson family blues.
I also seen you playing the mandolins. It was pretty.
Yeah, just having a little fun on it. Somebody had the chords written out for me, though.
Yeah, I showed them that.
Hey, boys, they're going to play a song, and I'd like you to come in and help sing this, Brady and Riley.
My wife just lost her
sister. Oh, yes, that's, and our condolences and everybody in the Breezeway.
God loves her, she's in a better place now. So.
Yes, that was my godmother, I do believe. God loves her.
Very sad, guys. Well, it's good to have you two young guys on the show again. He's going to take this one. You guys all, every time I'm around, I get you guys to do some George Jones. And you're feeling better? I know you have a little rough go there. I keep my eye on you, too.
Again, thanks, Brady and Beeps.
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Guys, here's a little George Jones. Hey, buddy. Something and that we're quite proud of. Notice the son and the father. The
love. Yeah, I almost got tears here watching. This brought back memories, so it's good to see the love and the respect between the two of you and the fun you had.
Well, to be honest, Beeps, I'm quite proud of this, and I could probably say not only is he my father, but he's probably like my best friend. I hear you. Like him and I do, we do a lot of stuff together. Good or bad? Good. Yeah, but
You guys are doing a great job with those boys.
Thank you.
Always keeping an eye on them too. That's something to see.
That's one of my best favorite shows because it's so down to earth, you know, and that's what I think it's all about, you know, keeping it country. Not only the music, but the way we live, our lifestyles and our friendships.
Amen.
Well, it was great to see. It was really great to see you guys.
Again, thank you.
We're going to get to do a couple more here, and we're going to close it out. And what happens when the camera goes off is what people miss behind the scenes. So, but we are going to get you to do a couple more, so you can go through your list, boys, and pick out a couple of your favorites for everybody out. And like, thank everybody.
I think you should do Rose of Paradise. Dad.
I like Rose of Paradise.
Family-wise,
Will and Jennings. I'm a Will and Jennings. And I didn't really do a whole bunch of his tonight because I know somebody loves him.
Yeah, I love him. I'm a big George. I like him all. George is my favorite. From him.
But anyways, because he does a great job on it. But anyways, Will and Jennings done a song about when he had a daughter. It's not supposed to be that way. Now, it's really slow, but it's what it is I want you to pay attention. For those out there in
Facebook land,
if you have a daughter, I want you to listen to this song. It's not supposed to be that way. You're supposed to know that I love you. If I can't be there to console you, like the other children, you're gonna grieve a dream or two. But be careful what you're dreaming, 'cause in your dreams will be. You're supposed to know that he loves you, but it don't matter anyway. If I can't be there to hold you. Now this is the dangerous part of the song. Go out to play this evening. Play with fireflies. You rush to meet your lover, and play with the real fire till dawn. Not supposed to be that way. You're supposed to know your dad loves you, but it don't matter anyway. If I can't be there, so be it. Don't matter anyway, because your daddy will always love you.
I never heard that one before myself. I'm gonna look it up now. Great tune, great tune.
Oh, you'll ever post it in the morning.
It'll be on Facebook. It's called Not Supposed to Be That Way.
Yeah.
So we're gonna do one more here before we sign off, and anyways, on behalf of Fran and Bees here, and all the people that came out tonight, and all the people on Facebook.
There's quite a few out there, you know. I keep an eye on the numbers, and the numbers that I'm getting back here are really impressive for me. And like I said, I can't thank everybody enough. I would never expected to get that kind of views. And
before I forget, I've been looking at the sticker back here, WNMC 90.7 FM, Ben Hamper. Down in Michigan.
You want to hear country music?
On Sundays, from 10 till noon, he plays. It's on the internet. You can check it out.
You might even hear a little Harold McIntyre and Stephen Beebe on there if you're lucky enough.
So I just want to let Ben know I appreciate it the first time. Well, Donnie Thomas sent my CD down there and he played my song and I sat there and cried because I never thought I'd be on the radio. And I think he played like a Hank tune or something like that right after me. I wish my dad was here. But anyway,
thanks very much, Ben Hamper, for all you do for...
thank you guys, too, for making this a special night for Breezeway for father and son.
Thank you.
Something
you'll be able to... Thanks for pushing us.
Thank you.
For pushing me.
Thank you.
I think it was you that kept the comments going, though.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, I did. I just had to poke in there, and that's why I was slowing down. That's all.
Anyway, I said to Justin, I said, you know, we need to get these two kids. I call them kids. I'm the old guy here.
Yeah.
Then you come back to Snow Road in September and hopefully come back and spend at least one day with us and do some stuff and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
That's a family thing, and it's one of those ones where you can have a really good time if you want to, right? Right, guys?
Yeah. Awesome.
Actually, I think it's mandatory. A good time.
I was going to do Waylon's tune here, Rose in Paradise, but I have this...
Do something a little upbeat, closer it with.
Okay. You know, pick me up on your way, I know everything.
What's my line?
I think an old guy taught me. this is a Waylon tune here.
Great.
Long ago and far away, I turned the world all the way, just because you asked me. I can't hear no other feel, just full of invisible truth. It don't matter, and I'll do girl anything you ask. But as long as things are right in you, it don't matter if I'll do anything you ask me to do.
We're going to be down at Cheers in Trenton with Rob Hood.
Looking forward to them, so tune in at 7 o'clock, or better yet, get down there and get early.
Yes.
Get a table, you reserve a table, and get yourself some good chicken wings there at Cheers.
You're going to get some hot picking down there, and some
Scott,
great food down there.
There's some great hot sauce
awesome.
Down there.
Fish and chips are really good. Yeah.
Yeah, good sound system.
Yeah, Scott McLean's got a... beautiful sauce he makes it, and he sells it there. You can have on the wings, and they got beer. And so if you imbibe a little bit, then they've got that to me myself. No, I won't be, but I'll leave that to you fellas.
Thanks, Gibby.
Thank you very much.
We're gonna run into each other.
Thanks very much, Study.
Thank you.
It's good to see you. We'll see you in September. Thank the American Boys.
All the Americans up on them. Thank you, Jeff and Fred.
Thanks to Jill and Brenda.
Yep.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, thank you.
There's the camera.
Yeah, behind the scenes. They don't get enough credit.
Okay, until next week in the Breezeway, keep your beer on ice and your sticks handy.
For scoring goals against Washington.
Woo!